गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज चैप्टर 4 हीट फॉर क्लास 7 सब्जेक्ट साइंस. दिस इज द लेक्चर 6 ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड इन द एंड आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग होमवर्क सॉल्यूशन ऑफ लेक्चर 5 ऑल्सो. द क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आई गिव यू यस्टरडे फॉर लेक्चर 5 दैट आई विल डिस्कस टुडे. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. टॉपिक्स टू बी डिस्कस्ड. So today we are going to discuss land and sea breeze, radiation and type of clothes. For clothes we have already have a small introduction in the starting of the chapter. Today we will learn about the other type of things, like what are the dark clothes and how they are helpful, all these things. So land and sea breeze. The blowing of sea breeze and land breeze in coastal areas is generally occurred due to the convection of heat in air. Yesterday we have studied convection of heat, right? So this land and sea breeze are the result of convection of heat in air. In coastal areas during the daytime, the breeze generally flows from the sea towards the land, and during the night time blows from the land towards the sea. So what happens in coastal area during the daytime? The breeze is generally flowing from the sea towards the land, and during the night time it is blowing from the land towards the sea. So this is happening in coastal areas. Sea and land breezes are actually convection of heat. So sea and land breeze are what? It is a convection of heat. During the day, the land heats up more than water. So during the day, land is more heated than water. So you will feel that water is very much cold. Due to this, the air over the land becomes hotter. If the land is more hot, so what will happen? The air above the land will also become hot. And lighter, and it will become lighter also, and rises up, and then it gets rises up also. So the air from the sea, which is cooler, and heavier, rushes to take the place created by the hot rising air. Therefore, a sea breeze blows during the day. During the night, the land loses heat faster than water and becomes cooler. So what happens during the night? The land loses heat faster, okay, than water, and becomes cooler. So the land is becoming cooler at night. And the air over the sea is now warmer. And the air which was over the sea will be warmer. Due to which it rises up, and the cooler air over the land rushes to take its place. Therefore, we observe a land breeze at night. So this thing happened. Here in this picture, it will be clear to you that in the daytime, land is hot and this water body is cool. Okay, and in the night time, what is happening? Water is hot and the land is cool. So this is because land and sea breeze are there, fine, in daytime and in night time. Now what is radiation? The mode of transfer of heat. I told you that there are three modes of transfer of heat. One is conduction, then it's convection, and then it's radiation. So we are discussing the third mode today, that is radiation. So it is a mode of transfer of heat through which heat energy from a hot body, okay, heat energy from a hot body to a cold body by means of heat rays. So the heat energy is getting transferred from the hot body to the cold body by the means of heat rays without any material medium. There is no material medium, but this heat rays are getting transferred from hot to cold body. Fine. So this transfer of heat between hot to cold body without any medium, this is known as radiation. Example, the sun heat reaches the earth by the process of radiation. So what we call sun rays, sun radiations, right? So the sun is also giving the heat to the earth by the process of radiation. And you know that solar energy is an abundant source of energy and it will never get exhausted also. It's an inexhaustible source of energy and it is also coming in the form of radiation from sun to earth. The sun is very far away from the earth. The sun is very far away from the earth, that much you cannot imagine also. And there is mainly an empty space vacuum. So the sun is far from earth. Earth has an atmosphere, but between the sun and earth there is lot more of space. There is no atmosphere also. So that is an empty space. That means that is a vacuum. Between the sun and earth, even the heat from the sun reaches the earth. There is a vacuum, there is an empty space. Then also the radiations of the earth is going to reach to the, the radiations of the sun is reaching towards the earth. That means the radiation can also transfer through a vacuum or it can also transfer through a empty space. Fine. This is due to the fact that sun being extremely hot emits invisible heat radiation or infrared rays in all direction. Sun is very hot, that's why it is secreting or it is emitting invisible heat radiation in all the directions, in all the possible directions. These radiations travel through the vacuum between the sun and the earth at a very high speed and ultimately reach us on the earth. So these radiations are traveling from the vacuum between the sun and the earth at a very high speed and ultimately reaching us on the earth. Therefore, we can say that the transfer of heat from a hot object to a cold object. Okay, so the transfer of heat from a hot object to a cold object by the process of radiation does not require any medium. So now we can conclude that the transfer of heat from a hot object to a cold object by the process of radiation does not require any medium. Okay, in our daily life activities we have many situations where heat is transferred by radiation through air. Example, depending on the temperature of surroundings, our body too gives heat to the surrounding or receive heat from the surrounding by radiation. Fine. So it depends on the circumstances, that what kind of circumstances we have around us. Our body is also giving and receiving heat in the form of radiation. So if a hot utensil filled with hot milk is kept away from the flame, then it cools down by transferring to the surrounding by radiation. You can take example of this. If you keep the hot milk away from the flame, what will happen? It will cool down after some time. That means it is transferring its radiation of heat to the atmosphere. And that is not visible also. And there is no visibility. If we stand next to a burning fire, this you must have observed, then we feel the heat of the fire falling on our face. Okay, the heat is transferred from the fire to our face by the process of radiation. So when you are standing near to a fire also, you feel that there is a heat, fine, and you feel that your face is getting heated. So that transfer of heat is also because of radiation. Now we are going to talk about clothes. During hot summer days, people prefer to wear white clothes or light colored clothes. Why? Because light color clothes absorb less heat from the sun. Okay, so light color clothes absorb very less heat from the sun. Right, black color clothes absorb lot of heat. And hence, keep us cool and comfortable in hot weather. While in the cold winter days, people prefer to wear dark clothes because the dark color clothes absorb more heat rays from the sun and keep us warm in winter season. So that's why people wear black light clothes in summers and dark clothes in winter, because light clothes will not absorb much heat from the sun and dark clothes will absorb much heat from the sun. So this is preferable in wearing in winter, and light clothes are preferable in wearing in summers. Now homework for today is you need to solve the NCERT question number 4, 5, 6 and 11. For your convenience, I am giving you question here also, that what is question number 4. So in question number 4, you need to do match the following. If you have your book, you can do this question in your book as well. Land breeze blows during, in column A, it's written. Second is sea breeze blows during. Third is dark color clothes are preferred during. Fourth is light color clothes are preferred during. In column second, summer, winter, day, night. Fine. Next question. Discuss why wearing more layers of clothing during winter keep us warmer than wearing just one thick piece of clothing. So just now we have discussed, so you can write this answer you need to write this answer in your notebook. Question number 6 is, look at the figure and mark where the heat is being transferred. By conduction, by convection, and by radiation. So this is the figure. It is, yesterday I gave you the answer from this figure. Okay, you can take help for that also. And you can write this answer in your book if you have your NCERT book. And if you don't have your NCERT book, you can draw this complete diagram in your notebook, and then you can label the labelings for conduction, convection and radiation. Next question is, stainless steel pans are usually provided with copper bottoms. The reason for this could be that, first, copper bottom makes the pan more durable. Second, such pans appear colorful. Third, copper is a better conductor of heat than stainless steel. Fourth, copper is easier to clean than the stainless steel. So you can give this answer. If you have book, you can do it in your book. Now we are going to discuss homework solutions of lecture 5 that I have given you in homework yesterday. Okay, so question number 7 I gave you. This was the first question that I gave you yesterday. That was, in places of hot climate, it is advised that the outer walls of houses be painted white. Explain. So the solution is, in places of hot climate, it is advised that the outer wall of houses be painted white, because white color reflects back most of the heat that is incident on it, as white is a poor absorber of heat. This helps in keeping the house cool. Fine. So we have studied today also that in summers people try to wear light and white color clothes, and in winter people wear black color clothes. So this is the reason, because the white is a poor absorber of heat and it will keep the house also cool. When we talk about a house which is there at a hotter climate, and if you are wearing white color clothes during summers, it will keep you also cool, because white is a poor absorber of heat. Next question was, 1 liter of water at 30 degrees Celsius is mixed with 1 liter of water at 50 degrees Celsius. The temperature of the mixture will be, so the options are A, 80 degrees Celsius, B, more than 50 degree Celsius but less than 80 degree Celsius, C 20 degree Celsius, D between 30 and 50 degree. So what is the answer? Solution is, the temperature of the mixture will be between 30 degree and 50 degree. Why? Because hot water loses the heat and simultaneously cold water gains heat. This keeps the temperature in between 30 degree and 50 degree Celsius. So this is the answer. Because hot water will lose the heat and simultaneously cold water will gain the heat. So temperature will be ranging between 30 to 50. Next is question number 9. An iron ball at 40 degrees Celsius is dropped in a mug containing water at 40 degrees Celsius. The heat will A. flow from iron ball to water, B. not flow from iron ball to water or from water to iron ball, C. flow from water to iron ball, D. increase the temperature of both. So what will happen? Answer is B. Not flow from iron ball to water or from water to iron ball, because both of them have the same temperature of 40 degree Celsius. Fine, if the temperature is same, then there will be no flow. Okay, this I have explained you during the conduction of heat. That if the temperature is same, then there will be no transfer of heat. Question number 10. A wooden spoon is dipped in a cup of ice cream. Its other end becomes cold by the process of conduction. B option, becomes cold by the process of convection. C option, becomes cold by the process of radiation. And in D, does not become cold. So what can be the answer? Answer is D. It does not become cold. And why it does not become cold? Because yesterday we have studied that word plastic are what? They are bad conductors of heat. They are insulators. So if they are bad conductor of heat, why the heat will get transferred? Fine. That's all for today. Thank you.